Hello YouTube, this is Prometheus 1979-9791. I'm going to show you how I make a quick fire using one piece of paper. And I'm only going to use half of this, so it will be one piece. Paper went under there. Okay. Take it, wad it up into small balls. One piece of paper, that's all I need. Sometimes I'll take a piece of paper like this. I don't know if I'm in frame or not. Sorry if I'm not. And I'll twist it like I'm trying to make cordage. And I'll leave the ends flared. And then, here, let me see. Okay, there we go. And then I double it up, twist these two around. So, you've got, sorry, I'm trying to look at this while I'm kind of next to it. See how it's flared out on those tips? It's twisted up here. This will catch fire. And this, since it's been compacted and condensed, will burn longer, helping get the fire going. Okay, that's it. That's the paper. Gotta have tinder. A little bit of tinder. Start out with just a tiny little bit. Make a little teepee around the paper. Get your fire starter. Gonna use the Gerber Bear Grills fire starter. I can usually get these sparks just to go right where I want them every other time. There we go. Normally I can get that in about two or three strikes, but it's kind of hard getting it in there around the wood. A little bit of tinder there. There we go, fire. I stay in practice with my fire starters. I start my fires on my wood stove with them. Not that it's really that complex that you need to practice at it so much. Gives me something to do. Make sure this little bit of tinder gets going. I also have the fan blowing this way, so it distributes the heat better. That's part of why I was having such a problem. Got a bit of wind blowing in there. Okay. I just feed a few of these till flame gets a little bit bigger. And then I toss in a bigger log. Not much bigger. I find that working with size chain, or with a size chain method with wood is the best. It just, the smaller stuff burns up quicker and easier, and it lights the little bit bigger stuff, and that lights a little bit bigger stuff, and before you know it, you got a raging fire and your house is getting warm. It's actually pretty cold in here today. It's not that bad outside. We've got trees that shade our house pretty well, so it doesn't really get too hot in here. In fact, we really don't even have need for an air conditioner through the summer. In fact, all we got is like a 1500 BTU air conditioner in the kitchen, and you can turn that on and it cools down the whole place even more if it's getting too hot. So there you have it. Now it's going to catch that bigger log on fire. And I don't actually need all that kindling. I'm just burning up what I brought in. Went out and split it. Okay, a little bit bigger piece there. That ought to catch pretty good. And this is the knife that I use for the batoning. It's the Gerber Bear Grills edition survival knife. I don't know what they call it exactly. A friend of mine gave me this. It's had most of the wear done by him. That's kind of why I liked it so much, is all the wear that it's got on the coating. Gives it a nice look. I like that. It's actually a nice heavy knife. Works pretty good for the batoning. I can't quite remember. I think this steel is the 7CR 17 MOV. So, pretty good steel. I'm not like a giant fan of Gerber or Bear Grylls. Actually, Bear Grylls I think is pretty cool, but I've never really had a problem with Gerber products at all. They seem to make a pretty good product. There's the Firestarter. I did a comparison video of this Gerber Bear Grylls Firestarter versus the Swedish Fire Steel Scout 2.0. This actually comes with a fire steel there. It's like the most used item on this tool, apparently. It's kind of in rough shape, but it ought to start a lot of fire still. Seems like overall a pretty good knife. And you can see my fire is looking pretty good. Let's take you around here and get you a look inside there. Pretty cool, huh? Got it going. But yeah, I just get tired of lighting fires with matches and lighters and stuff, and kind of don't get as much of the outdoors as I'd like to get. So sometimes I just kind of have my own campfire inside and start it with the ferrocerium fire starter. This little bit of wood right here will put it up to probably close to 80 degrees here in this house in just a short amount of time. And probably can't see what type of stove. It's a Fisher. It's actually a really good stove so far. Just been enjoying it. Like having wood heat. It's cheap. Where I lived at before, we used to use a oil burning stove. It's called a Toyo stove. And we were probably, we were pretty frugal with it. We only spent about $600 a year heating the house through the winter, which is kind of pathetic since, you know, winter is usually only supposed to be about 3 or 4 months or whatever. But people that moved in there after we moved out ended up spending $500 a month on that oil. And when we lived there before also, using that Toyo stove, we were also running space heaters to keep the place warm. And it was running us anywhere from $200 to $300 a month for our power bill. Since we moved here and we've got this wood stove, we've got basically our power bill is probably around $50 to $60, maybe $70 at the most, at the very most, per month. So it's pretty good. So you can see we got some coals going in there. Fire's looking good. Just thought I'd let you spend a few minutes watching how I make a fire in my wood stove, just for fun. But anyway. Too bad you can't be here warming yourself by the fire with me, but probably some of you down in like Arizona and California are probably wishing you needed a fire to stay warm. I was talking to somebody in Arizona today and they said that it's about 100 degrees down there, so yep, I guess I'm kind of glad it's not 100 here. I don't really like too much heat, honestly, but I like to be warm, comfortable. So thanks again for watching. This is Prometheus 1979 9791 saying stay sharp.